So hello friends, Dr. Manil Verma, welcome you all in this lecture on the molecular modeling through Siesta. This is actually the hands-on tutorial for the beginners. This is lecture number 13 and the title of this lecture is Studies on Optical Properties. So outlines of this lecture is the first one is obviously the objectives of this lecture and the theory behind the optical studies of the materials and the system methods of optical calculations. This is the third point and the system input files for the optical run using system and optical post-processing tools of a system, then the probable that outcomes of this tool, and I will introduce my research group also, and the final the acknowledgement. The objectives of this lecture is to use the system pre and post-processing tools for the study of optical properties, and the main optical properties covered here are the absorption coefficient, optical conductivity, real and imaginary dielectric functions, reflectance, refractive index, etc. And all these properties are very useful to study the various optoelectronic devices. And for example, one can say that light emitting diode, organic light emitting diode, or polymeric light emitting diode, some solar cells, and light emitting electrochemical cells too. And this is one sample figure, including here, and taken from the Journal of Physical Chemistry. Randomly I have taken this figure to show how one can get this optical property and different figures related to optical properties by using system. This is the dielectric functions, optical coefficient, reflectivity, and that optical conductivity, etc. Actually, I have mentioned earlier in my previous lectures that I will not going to the details of theoretical studies or the detailed mathematics, because this is for the beginners. But here I will recommend it to refer, if you want to know the details of this optical properties, so please refer the optical properties of solids by this Anthony Marks and the optical properties of solid by this Sutton, and these are the good reference books. And I have also given some links to know the details of this theory of optical properties. So actually this theory of optical properties concentrated on several points, from the viewpoints of quantum mechanics. The interaction of the photons with an electrons in the system is described in terms of time dependent perturbation of ground electronic state. Second, the optical the transitions between occupied and unoccupied states are caused by photon absorption or emission. These are several points, and I am giving emphasis on these two or three points. The third one is the spectral resulting from the excitation that can be thought of as the joint density of states between the conduction band and the valence band. And this dielectric function is actually the sum of this real and imaginary part, and out of which this imaginary part is directly related to electronic band structure of a material and describe the absorption behavior. And this is that mathematical terms related to imaginary dielectric part, where M is the absorption dipole matrix, I and J are the initial and final states respectively, F1 is the Fermi, obviously the Fermi distribution function, and of ith state, E1 is the energy of electrons and of this ith state, and K is the crystal wave vector. And that real part is represented by this mathematical terms, which is extracted from the imaginary part by using this Cramer's Kronig rule, and where this P implies the principal value of the integrals. So epsilon 1 and epsilon 2, this allows the calculation of important optical functions, and by using this one can calculate other important parameters, that one is the refractive index, extinction coefficient, sensor reflectivity, and by using this mathematical terms. So other optical parameters like energy loss functions, absorption coefficient, frequency dependent optical conductivity can be calculated by these expressions. And maximum terms are that conventional terms used in simple solid physics book. So I'm not going to the details of each and every parameters here. Here this omega CV is a transition probability per unit time. Now the system methods of optical calculation. The system methods of optical calculation, it is performed in the following four steps. Obviously the first step will be the geometrical optimization of the system under study, and I have mentioned earlier in one of my lecture how to optimize one system by using this mesh cutoff, k-points, and lattice parameter optimization. There I have introduced one of my scripts of the optimization of the system also by using this sufficient numbers of conjugate gradients. And for the Siesta runoff optical calculation, we introduce some required flags or blocks in the input file, and then this will generate the data files by using some post-processing tools. One is the input and this is the optical, these are the post-processing tools which is given in Siesta utils and optical directory. And then the plotting of data, this is the final terms generated by post-processing tools, and we can plot this data by using XMLS genuplots or other some other plotting tools. So Siesta input file for optics. So in the regular FDF file, that Siesta input file, we include these flags in that FDF file. One is optical calculation true, and this is one block to give this optical mesh, which actually the mesh size used for the integration of integration across Brillouin zone. And this is optical offset mesh, one should write here true. Optical polarization type is polarized here. I generally use this, and you can also use polycrystal or unpolarized too. And for details, you can go to the system manual. And this block optical vectors, this vector actually gives the direction for the electric field or the light propagation. And here I have taken this direction is along x-axis. And you have seen in several papers that these optical properties are studied in two perpendicular direction, one towards the plane and the second one is normal to the plane. So it is generated by changing this direction from this optical vectors. This is along x-axis. If you want to study along y-axis, then you have to put one here in the y term, or you can also calculate these optical parameters along z-axis by putting this one here in the z-direction. And its optical broadening, it is 0.2 here, and optical energy minimum and maximum value can be taken in the different range depending on different materials. And in general, this is these are the default value. So optical energy maximum is 20 electron volt here, and minimum is 0.0 electron volt. This is the screenshot of that screen. I have calculated that optical properties that in that util directory in that optical in util in optical directory some Fortran files are there, and one can compile these Fortran files and use as a post-processing tools. And how to use this, we will go into the details and details of these in the demonstration part, so I'm not going to the detail here. And outcome after successful Siesta run for the optical calculation, one will have different optical parameters: the epsilon real out, the real part of dielectric function, epsilon imaginary out, and imaginary part of dielectric function. These are the data files: refractive index, refractive index, absorption index, absorption coefficient, reflectance, and conductivity is optical conductivity in ohm meter inverse. By using these data files, one can have interactive plots. This can be generated by using different plotting tools, and that dielectric loss can be calculated by using the parameters obtained by this optical calculation. So this is my research group. Some of them are experimental research scholars, and most are working in now the DFT based mathematical calculation. So that I am finally gratefully acknowledge the kind support of my guide, Dr. Rakesh Chandra Gular, for his blessing. And I'm very much thankful to Professor Ravin Pandey from Michigan Tech University for their valuable discussions, and Dr. Rodrigo for time to time help. So don't forget to give your valuable feedback. Thank you. And now let's start the demonstration. I'm using Ubuntu in this demonstration part. So this is the desktop of I'm using this in virtual box. So this is the folder where I have taken one optimized structure of silver iodide molecules, just two atoms, to save time. And this is where that input file is. Where the input file? This is the input file. So simple that system name and system labels, number of items, other parameters are the same as general input file. And here, for optical calculation, I have introduced these additional terms, that optical mesh 20-20-20 is here, and also in the presentation I have mentioned all these parameters. So one can take this flex from that test files in silicon optical. There will be some silicon optical test files here, and one can copy those parameters from here. And where that SI optical, let's see. So this one, and here this optical FTF, and one can copy all these terms from here to this optical file. So when we run this file, one will get so let me run this by using simple Siesta executive file and .fdf, and this is t. So depending on the number of items and types of system, this may take some more time, but to save time I have just taken two items as a molecules of silver iodide. And now, okay, so calculation is completed. Now we have this AGI EPS IMG file generated here, and which can be used for the further calculation, further generation of data file. So let me first copy this to any separate directory. Let me make one separate directory for data file here by using this, and copy this cp store dot img to this data file. So cd this. So this is that AGI mol.eps.img. But now I will convert this EPS.img file into different data files by using post-processing tools of Siesta. So let me show you how to compile those post-processing tools in Siesta utils. So I'm just going through this clicking different folders here, and where the system optical, this one is the optical files, and here two terms, input.f and optical.f is there, and for details one readme file is also here to help you, and one can read this input file and that compilation process are also mentioned in this. So let me generate this by using Fortran. I have G Fortran here, so G Fortran. Let me use this flag and put so input is generated, and then G Fortran. Second is the optical file is also here, so optical. So by using this simple command, one can compile this. So now we have this input and optical binary file, and one can take this input and optical binary file to generate some data file for optical properties. So I have just copied these two input data files in my bin directory, so I can directly use those binary files in that particular folder. But you can also copy this input and optical files from this, and you can run and generate data files. So for example, that here this SIEPS IMG file is there, so one can use this input and let SI this one, and then optical, two commands only. So we will have different data file here, and one can plot XM grace, absorption coefficient. So this is that optical plot here. This is the input, and one can decorate this optical plot by using that XM grace. So let me again show you that generation of this data files for optical run. That is, first I will use input and then optical. So it's not metallic, so I will use zero here, and now these are data files, and now I can plot this absorption coefficient, and this is the plot. And one can decorate this by using, by changing the colors, and taking circles, and for the publication purpose. So this is a very good plot of absorption coefficient of silver iodide molecules. So one can also plot different refractive index also. Some grace refractive index, that foil reflectance, let's say reflectance. This is that reflectance, the silver iodide molecules. So by using this, one will have a very good, very interactive plots. Previously I have studied some materials and plotted this absorption coefficient, and this is the reflectance also. So I think demonstration is over, and please don't forget to send me the feedback regarding this presentation, regarding this